י"א, ולווה ער בעומק יוסר, מה שישראל נקרא בשם צבאות הוויה, and to explain in greater depth this that Israel are called the army of Havaya, the Shem Tzvos, who Shem Kadosh, that the name Tzvos is a holy name, whom Yahazayin Shemos Shenam Nimchakim, it's one of the seven names that is not erased, V'Shem Zen Iskale Al Yidei HaNevim, and this name was revealed to the Nevim, the B'Torah Lo Nizkar Shem Tzvos, and the Torah, the name Tzvos, is not mentioned. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, Al Yidei HaNevim, Brachos Lamed Aleph Beis, V'Nisbor B'Torah Or V'Torah Schaim Rish Parshas Bo, the difference between Tzvos Havaya and Havaya Tzvos. And how it's only in Olamos Biyah. The B'Torah of V'Nizkarak Tzvos Havaya, in the Torah only is mentioned the army of Havaya, V'Kayel Yisrael, and that it refers to Yisrael. V'Tzarich Lahavin Ma'u Zeh HaMaila, needs to be understood, what is this great thing? Kolomar B'Shvil Eza Ma'ilu Madrega, Nikrao Yisrael B'Shem Tzvos Havaya. That is to say, because of what great level are Yisrael called the army of Havaya? V'atuar hazen yitan Yisrael b'yitzias m'mitzrayim davka. And this description of Yisrael was given to them when they went out of Mitzrayim specifically. Acha'inyin hu, but the concept is the hine isa b'medrash rabba shmos per gimel, parsha gimel. Shmi atav mevakish li'eda. L'fim ma'isa yani nikra. The Moshe wanted to know Hashem's name, so the Medrash says that Hashem answered him, "Do you want to know my name? I'm called according to my acts." Ugeshani nilchamim harishayim ani nikra tzvos, and it goes through a number of names there, and things that Hashem does. And then it says that when I battle with the wicked, I'm called tzvos. Imkein uvan deshem tzvos hushem demilchama. So it's understood then that the name Tzvos is a name of battle. V'chein Isa b'shari ora Reb Yosef Kikaktilia. That the shari ora is a sefer about the Shemos Hashem from this early mekubal. The Shem Tzvos hu b'netzach v'hod misham nimshachos kol milchamos. The name Tzvos is from Netzach and Hod, and from there comes all the battles. Kol milchamos shebe olam, all the battles in the world. What is the connection between battle and Netzach and Hod? That from Netzach and Hod should come all of the battles in the world. Why specifically those spheros? Now this concept of conquering, victory in battle, nitzachon, is something that only a great person does. The mishu shafal be'erech, that somebody who is lowly in comparison. Hine im yomar adam kenegdo lo yinatzeach. If a person says something against them, they won't stand up for themselves. Ela yochol anus azus, but they might just say something brazen, but not that they stand up for themselves and overcome that challenge. Hadafka mishu hu gadol, specifically somebody who is great. Har yesh bo midas hanitzachon, so he has this attribute of conquering and victory over the enemy. Dechasher yomar adam davar negdo o yaseh davar sheino kiritzono. That when a person does something against someone, or does something that contrary to his will, so the person will stand up for themselves to bring out to light their righteousness, their correctness. And this is what our sages said. In Yoma, called Talmid Chacham, Shino Nokim, Venoter Kenacha, Shino Talmid Chacham, that any Torah scholar that does not take revenge and retribution, like a snake. He's not a Talmid Chacham. Upirush Rashi, Rashi explains, Nokim v'nikmaso v'noter eva b'libo k'nachash, that is, he takes revenge and he guards the hatred in his heart like a snake, or the enmity in his heart like a snake for somebody who does against the Torah, against them as a Talmid Chacham, v'nadiuk nachash davka mevorsham. And look over there, where it scrutinizes the idea of why a snake specifically, in the Gemara. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, you, what pleasure do you have from this, that the snake doesn't get pleasure from its bite and so forth, that everything tastes like dirt to it. The Gemara asks, doesn't it say in the Torah, do not take revenge, do not guard it in your heart? But nonetheless, it's permissible for the Torah scholar to be vengeful and guard it in his heart and hold the grudge. Amnam hanakima vanatira, but this vengefulness and grudge shmutaros l'talmid chacham, that are permissible to the Torah scholars, but yosu shmuchoyev ba, and further that they're obligated, enu chas v'shalom hanakima vanatira hamor b'torah, it's not, God forbid, the same thing as the Torah tells us not to do. That, like our sages said, that's in the Torah, it's referring to money. That is to say that the vengefulness and grudge that the Torah scholar is obligated in is not for money. It's not anything that comes from money. But nonetheless, it's still considered a vengefulness and grudge. But there's a stipulation in this matter. He must be a Torah scholar of a Talmid Chacham. And a student of wisdom is someone who receives from wisdom and is subjugated and nullified to it. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, Mina Chachma Torah or Parshas Yisro, Softi Bora Maskil Moshe Yedaber. That is, all of his actions and the things that he's involved with are all for the sake of wisdom. That this in general is the concept of victory. That specifically because he's a Talmid Chacham, that he's a Gadol, he's receiving from Chachma, from the highest level. So that's why he's allowed to overcome and stand up for the Torah and for wisdom. And so that's why victory, specifically with someone who's big, who's great, v'chol mi shegodol yoser, anyone who is greater, midas hanisachon hu biyoser etzlo, this concept of victory is more prominent by them. L'chein ha-melech shegodol mikol ha'am, therefore the king who is greater than all the nation, d'zeo milas ha-melech shu b'chir ha'am v'godol mihem, v'kamo shekasuv gabi shaul, that this is the greatness of the king, that he's the chosen of the nation and greater than all of them, like it says by Shaul, and the Rebbe says on the bottom, Lechina Melech, and therefore the king, Gabi Shaul by Shaul, Lahir Miyom Hashem, Shemaim Rezal, Kol Talmid Chacham Shino Nokim Chulu, that statement that any student of wisdom that does not take revenge, Ba'achrei Maim Rezal, it comes right after the statement of our sages that why did was Shaul punished? Because he forgave and he was you foregoed his honor. So that meaning he did not have the nitzachon he needed. He was obligated in the nitzachon and he didn't do it. V'in ish mibnei Yisrael tov mimeno. And it says by Shaul, there's no one in Israel better than him, mishichmo v'mala gavoh mikol ha'am, that from his shoulders upwards and upwards he was higher than the rest of the nation. So he was a gadol. So therefore, by him, you have this concept of victory. Yosel more legalus ritzono v'cheftzo, to reveal his desire and will, ulehotzi nitzchono, and to come out victorious. And this is also the source for battle, to bring out his victory. Why the king will battle, that with the battle there are two concepts. The first is to take booty and get treasures from the battle, and the second, the concept of the battle is to come out victorious, the milchama lishlo shalal v'levoz vaz, who milchama shel koach v'gvura bilvad, that a battle that's only to take treasures and to get booty is only a battle of strength and show of force alone, or milchama b'chlalos. But the battle in general, the concept of battle, klomer haskala shebe milchama, hu lahotzi anitzachon, that's in order to actually be victorious in it, sheyihye kechefto v'ritzono, that it should be according to one's will and desire. Amnam gamze inyan anitzachon udavka kashiyesh menaged hamoneo me'akev. That, but now this concept of victory is only when you have an enemy, somebody who's holding back and obstructing. V'az shayich nitzachon, that's when you can have this conquering, the below menaged, when you don't have an opposing force. Eino shayich inyan nitzachon klal, you can't have this concept of victory at all. Uman hig malchusu kechefzo, but he just can do conduct his kingdom according to his desire. When he desires something and there is someone who stops him, as omed b'nitzachon kenegdo, then he stands in opposition, umotzi nitzchono, and brings out his victory, b'shvil nitzuach ha'menaged, and in order to be victorious against this enemy, hari mevaz v'ez kol skulos ha'otzros tohon yakar, he will waste all of the treasures of the kingdom, that was gathered and brought into the treasury through a number of years, from generation after generation, and nothing was ever used of it for any other thing. And this treasure was hidden and sealed away from anyone seeing it. Now at the time of trying to conquer the battle, so he will spend all of these treasures. That's because this concept of victory is beyond all pleasure and desire and our will. And the Rebbe says on the bottom, "V'hulafi Rebbe chol zebarichus softi b'ramas chil tzidkas pirzono tofresh peites contrast drushe chasuna my mari pesach tofshintes contrast samechei." Then it talks about this concept of nitzaron and how it's higher than ratzon and oneg. Now all of this tremendous pleasure, an awesome pleasure that there is in the treasures of the kingship, And the storehouse is of honor. Hine einu tofes makom klal lagabi hanitzachon, and cannot compare at all to the king winning his battle. V'ulefi shemidas hanitzachon ulamayla me'oneg, and that is because the attribute of victory is higher than pleasure. V'od yoser, and even further, shegam chayev mashlich melech minegdo, that the king will even give up his life for it. U'mitzad godel hanitzachon omed be'atzmo b'kishrei hamilchama. And in order to have this great victory, the king himself will stand within the thick of battle. And that is because the concept of victory, being victorious, is rooted and planted in the essence of the soul, higher than all the revealed strengths of the soul. That is because it is higher than the light and the life force that comes in a revealed state. And for this reason, he gives up his life. And how much more so that he gives up and will spend the treasures and the pleasures of kings. In the order of this is the Be'ez Milchama, that at the time of battle, post Chimisa Otros, they open up the treasure houses, Venos Nimosomai de Saria Pekidim, Shem Pekidi Achayel, and they're given to the ministers of the generals who are in charge of the soldiers, Vakavana Bezahim Anshe Achayel. But the intention is for the soldiers themselves, Shem Davka Osim Sanitzachon, that they're the ones who actually win the battle. And the likeness of this is understood above, that you also have a kind of treasure house, and it's this idea of that which is hidden and sealed, like it says, that Hashem will open for you his good storehouse. And like our request in davening, and your good storehouse, please open for us. And the Yamim Noraim, and we say, and from your storehouse of free gifts, please have be gracious to us, and so forth. Shem utro sachsumim, that refers to the hidden, the sealed away treasures. Ubeisa milchama, and in the time of battle, poschim esa utros shemusrimu samaydei aydei pekidim, the treasure houses are opened and given to those who are in charge of us. Allegorically, that would be the Rabbanim and the leaders of Israel, Shem Bekidei Achayel, that they are the commanders of the army. Omnam Hakavana Hu Bishvil Achayel, but the true intention, though, is for the soldiers themselves, Lefi Shehein Heina Hamevim Esanitzachon, because they are the ones who actually fight and win the battle. And that's why Israel is called the Tzivos Savaya, Lefi Sheheim Anshei Achayel, because we are the soldiers, we are the actual soldiers, Sheheim Osim Ritzono Shel Makom, that we're the ones who fulfill the will of the omnipresent Linagid, Esaminagid, to conquer the opposing enemy, that which opposes, Ulehem Poschim Utzar Elyon, and it's for these soldiers of for Israel that are open the storehouses, poskim utzara elyon, the supernal storehouse, b'shvil nitzuach hamilchama, for winning the battle, and nagid esamin nagid, to oppose that which the opposer, the enemy.